the book called Eat, Pray, Love that came out about 15 years ago that maybe some of you have heard of. But it's basically a sort of story of religious pilgrimage by a woman named Elizabeth Gilbert, who is sort of lives in the secular world at the start of the book, is deeply dissatisfied with that world. I think she even worked in publishing. And at a certain point leaves that world, leaves her marriage, leaves her husband, leaves the life she expected to have, and goes on sort of a world tour that starts with the eating, which takes place in Italy, and moves on to the praying, which takes place in an Indian ashram in the subcontinent. And there she has these incredibly intense religious experiences that are, you know, do not fit at all within the secular materialist paradigm. But the upshot of those experiences is not a conversion to an Eastern religion. She doesn't become Hindu or become Buddhist or become Jain, nor does she sort of return to the sort of thin Protestantism that she was brought up with. She just sort of packages those religious experiences into a very personalized form of spirituality, a sort of church of the God within, basically, and then moves on to the third stage of the book where she falls in love with a handsome Brazilian divorcee in Bali. So it's basically like Augustine's Confessions, except but it is in the sense that it's a sort of culturally resonant story of a religious journey, a search for an encounter with God, but it doesn't end with conversion. And that I think is sort of a defining feature of what is right now the American religious center. It used to be that you would say that a kind of mainline Protestantism was the American religious center 50 or 60 or 100 years ago. Now I think you'd say it's this kind of spirituality that accepts that supernatural realities are there, but is very doubtful that any particular revelation, any particular institutional church, even if people belong to an institutional church to practice faith, could possibly hold, you know, the truth, capital T, inside its confines.